village this morning, and we're going to do a HEART seminar. HEART stands for Health Education Africa Resource Team, and we'll be teaching this morning on malaria and typhoid and hepatitis B. The problem in this village right now, of course, is malaria. Besides HIV and AIDS, it's very strong with HIV and AIDS. It's on the border of Tanzania. So any border town gets a lot of traffic. Most people catch HIV in Kenya in their home. That means that one person in that home, the husband or the wife, has contracted it someplace else and brought it home.
Can I tell you as adults? It's our decisions in our communities. How we're going to walk through this epidemic. Between 500 and 700 people are dying every day in Kenya.
We've never had such a seminar. It's one of its kind. It's the first. And you can judge this by the response. It's the first of its kind, because to those people who doesn't have television, who doesn't have a radio, this information was so strange to them. But when they came to HEART, when they came here, the HEART team was able to reach everyone.
We ask everybody to take the information that they get, disseminate it to their neighbors, to their children, on beyond, and they become ambassadors once they've gone through our seminars to continue the education.
It's killing our brothers, it's killing our sisters, it is killing our parents. So we need to go deeper. We need to move in the whole world so that the world can know about this pandemic.
And as we lie beneath the stars, we realize how small we are. If they could love like you and me, imagine what the world could be.
It's the Women Empowerment Employment Program. A lot of these women, when they find out they have AIDS or their husband dies of AIDS, they are no longer able to work. Well, if you can't work and you can't get funds, you cannot support your families. And most of these people do have families still they need support. So these widows have all these children. What are their options? So Vicky created the WEEP program. This is all 100% Vicky. But what's happening? You have a woman who now has hope. She has a job, she has medicine, her children have a future. What it is a cycle. It's going to change one village at a time. And it starts with the WEEP program.
Here I am, lost in the light of the moon that comes through my window. Of my memory divides the thorns from the roses. It's you and the roses.
Bridges Center is a rehabilitation center that started about 11 years ago in a slum area in the east part of Nairobi called Dandora. And we were getting our children from the dump yard that was around that place, and also from the streets of Nairobi.
You know, we see so much despair, and you spend so much time wondering what will happen to these kids, what will tomorrow look like for them. And when you see the joy in these kids, you know, it is an orphanage. And immediately, what do we think of when we think of orphanage? We think adoption. Let's take them. Let's take them back to America. You know what? This is Kenya's tomorrow. They are exactly where they're supposed to be.
You remember the best coming?
Yes.
In the man's presence?
Yes.
Praise God.
Yes. Love is touch. Touch is love. Love is reaching. Reaching love.
HEART goes to places nobody else goes. HEART gets in cars and we drive 8 to 10 hours outside of Nairobi, where there are no telephone lines, there are no televisions in a lot of instances. There is no way for that information to get other than by word of mouth. Let's get the right information to them first, and then let's build on it.
they've accepted to come down to the village level, a place maybe where even the president of Kenya doesn't know well. But they have accepted to come to the village level. We've shared our houses, small rooms with them. We've shared our food, you know, what we prepared at home. We've shared with them. We've shared many things with them.
Heart specifically takes the funds, and 94 to 97% of that money goes directly to the Kenyan people. That money came from the people in America. That money was going to change those women's lives forever. It may save their lives.
You walk on waves, you run with clouds, you paint the sky for me to see. Your majesty is why I sing.
Going forward, we're making a difference in people's lives, and I absolutely know that I'm doing exactly what I'm supposed to be doing with my life, and it's very exciting. Every day's different, every day's challenging, there's so many needs, but we're making a difference, and it's more than one by one. It's hundreds of people's lives have been touched because of heart. So I'm totally excited about what the future holds. Looking for property, looking for better vehicles. You know, we've come a long ways, we've got a long ways to go. Our work is both has a Christian emphasis, but it's a humanitarian work. I had one pastor say, this is Christianity with shoes on. That, you know, you're actually accomplishing a lot and you're changing lives and helping people. Heart will continue to grow. Right across the way here, we can just put a gateway right in our fence here. We border this property behind us. I can envision like a training center there and a conference room where other people could even rent and lease it. And we're growing so big, and I think we need to think big and think ahead. And you know, when you look at something like this, you think, well, you don't have any money. How would you ever do it? I don't know, but that's never stopped us before, you know. So not going to let it stop me now. Just if it's a vision from the Lord, it comes to pass.
I'm not afraid.